Hey everyone, welcome to the Horror Show. I'm Cecil Laird.
I'm Producer Dave.
And we are here with a very, very special presentation, you guys. This is going to be the first in a series of what I'm going to call flashback episodes. What these are going to entail are basically some older videos that David and I made, or Producer Dave and I made, sorry, oh my god. anyway, we've been making films together for a very, very long time. We've known each other since preschool. We went to the same preschool together. So since 3 years old, we've been in each other's lives in some way, shape, or form. So it's no surprise that we got into film together and we started making short films together and all kinds of, we haven't made a long film yet together, but
no.
We need to. We have a couple of ideas on that.
If you put
front,
all of our films together, it'd be a long film.
That's true. That's true. That's very true. We've been working together all along the way. He's been a driving force behind the scenes for the show, especially early on when we were doing all of our shorts and everything like that, and especially on Suite. So it's funny that we have this huge past that none of you guys have ever seen any of the work, and I frankly thought that...
I was happy with that.
Okay.
I was okay with that.
I wasn't. I wanted some sort of record of everything that we've done in the past, and luckily, an opportunity presented itself very recently with the combination of my absolute OCD-ness and hanging on to a VHS with all of our old films on it.
Yeah.
And thank you to Andrew, who managed to have the correct part to transfer the VHS to the digital format. We are now able to present all of our old films to you guys. There's not
for
a huge amount
worse.
Of them, for better or worse. You're going to see them. Definitely some are leaning more towards horror than others, but we're going to show you them all, and we're going to present both the actual films, and then we're going to be recording separate videos where David and I do commentary on these films as well. And then probably a third video for each one where we have Fuego, Brittany, Andrew, and anyone else that wants to come and react to these old films of Producer Dave's and mine. So it's going to be a fun series of videos, you guys. So flashback episode one, I think there's no better way to start than with our very first short film, which ended up being our longest film to date.
Yeah. Student film.
It was a student film. It was for when I went to ASU.
Your student film.
There were two classes that I was able to take. I majored in global business marketing with a minor in mass communications, and I ended up losing about a semester because I wanted to take film classes, but there was no film degree at the time. So I took about five different film classes, two of which were intro to pre-production and pre-production, and then there was intro to pre-production and then production. So I guess it was just pre-production and production. I don't know. It's been a long, long time, guys, unfortunately. But anyway, the first class was developing an idea and writing the script for a short film that you would then, in the second semester, which was the production class, film and create the film that you would then present as your final at the end of the class. And there was a big showing, and we did indeed show our film in front of the whole class. And I must say, ours was the only film that got two applause breaks. But yeah, that's, neither here nor there. But you guys are about to watch this film. It is, like I said, the longest one. It is a 15-minute short film that we made. We were very, very young. Must have been probably 19 or 20 because I just started college. Maybe even 18 still. But
the 2000s, wasn't it?
It must have been 2000.
99.
It must have been 2000 because I graduated in 99 and I think I did it in my sophomore year. So it must have been 2000. But 2000, 2001 anyway.
Yeah.
But yeah, so that would have put me at 20, 21 years old when we did this. I was largely behind the scenes, although I do have a cameo.
Yeah.
Producer Dave does not have a cameo, I don't believe, right? Or do you?
Yeah, no, I do.
Really? Where was it?
Yeah. Well, you'll see in the...
All right. That's true. You guys will see.
See if you can spot me, though.
See if you can spot producer Dave. but yeah, you guys are going to have a lot of fun with this, I hope. Anyway, thank you for bearing with this absolutely long intro, but we wanted to let you know what you guys are going to watch and why it looks as amateur as it does.
It used to be called standard definition.
Yes, exactly. So it's going to be a little bit blurry. If you want to shrink your window, it'll look a little bit better. but yeah, so thank you guys for checking it out. But without further ado, we now present Hidden Intent.
Hello? What?
Are you sure this is where you can reach?
Yeah.
The important thing in cases like these is to be patient. Nothing has ever been helped by flying off the handle.
So what do you have so far?
We found her in your house. She was attacked and killed by a sharp object, most likely a knife of some kind.
And what about the killer?
We're still gathering evidence. We haven't found the prints yet, but we have officers still searching the place. You might want to check into a motel for a while.
So how long before you find this guy?
Well, so far we don't have that much to go on. This guy was pretty clean.
I'm glad you're so impressed. Sounds like you're doing everything you can.
Listen, why don't you go home, both of you? You both look tired. I'll contact you when we have more information. Of course, if either of you had any information about the incident, you'd contact me, right?
Right.
Mr. Bannister?
If you won't do anything.
This is all my fault.
Where were you last night?
Huh?
Last night, where were you?
You know where I was.
Sarah again?
I don't want to talk about this.
Were you with her all night? Where else did you go?
It doesn't matter.
Fine, I'll go back in and tell the detective where I think you were last night.
Listen, I may be a bad husband, but I had nothing to do with this.
Then tell me where else you went.
Crossroads.
Fuck, Dave!
I had to. I needed it. Sarah doesn't ask questions. If I need to go for a walk at night, she doesn't grill me.
So the woman you're cheating on your now dead wife with doesn't give a shit about you. Nice to know. Was there anybody there at the time?
I don't know. Just the usual junkies.
Well, I'm not the Crossroads regular here, Dave. Enlighten me. Can you make out faces, descriptions, anything?
Look, they're just junkies. Nobody important.
Junkies have faces too.
There's an Indian. You know, as in feathers. His name's Terry P. something. We all call him TP. Get it?
Funny.
There's also this white guy. He's always real nervous, pissed off.
Nice to know who you're replacing us with.
You believe me about not hurting Maggie, right?
I know that in the time you don't spend fucking white trash like Sarah, you're hard up for money that you can smoke away with the dregs of society. I know your wife and my sister are dead, and now I know the police don't move fast enough. By the way, you should go see a doctor. You look like shit.
What do you want?
Just need to know who was here last night.
To what does this pertain?
Oh, just keeping one of your best clients out of jail.
Is this a police investigation?
No. Call it a friend's need to know.
Last night? There. Those two were.
Those two? Anybody else?
No. Mr. Bannister is always careful about making sure the place is pretty empty before he comes to do business.
I never told you who I was looking for.
Hey, he may be my best client, but he's also my most paranoid one. Figured it was only a matter of time before he got himself into some kind of trouble. And now you come looking for him? Go figure, huh?
I'm gonna need to ask you guys a few questions here.
Look, I don't know anything.
Are you TP?
Motherfucker, do I look like I wear featherheads and carry a fucking bow and arrow?
I'm TP, what the fuck do you want?
Finally, we're getting somewhere. Now I'm gonna need a little more information here, TP.
Anything to get you to leave me the fuck alone.
Good, good. Now you were here last night, right?
Yeah.
Look, I've been having someone tailed recently, and I need to know certain things about their activities here.
Look, you better be paying.
You, I don't know. Apparently you hang around here working off your debts to this place as you shoot up. You're just a fucking transient, so I'd watch your mouth. I need to know how much he spends, what kind of drugs he does, and who he owes.
What will you be doing for us, rich man?
Yeah, are we getting some money out of this?
Well, I don't expect you assholes to do charity work.
No, Kevin. I'm not kidding. The insurance company gave me $50,000. No, I didn't know.
So you're telling me you didn't even know she had a policy taken on herself? That in case anything happened to her, you would get this money?
I had no idea. Frankly, I'm surprised she didn't have the money go to her family.
Fine. I got a few things I gotta do today, one of which entails me seeing a friend of mine on the force who might be able to get you out of this. Do you have the money now?
Yeah. So just call me at the motel as soon as you find out.
The motel. Still not going home.
I can't. Not yet. I'll talk to you soon though, okay?
Sure. Yeah, hi, is this Sarah?
Yes.
Yeah, this is gonna sound strange, but how well do you know David Bannister?
Hello.
Okay, I just got off the phone with my guy in the force, and he says that he can get you off, but the payoff's pretty steep.
Fine. Just give him the insurance money. But then what happens to me?
Your name will be cleared. There'll be no further investigation and no one will come forward. Now I need you to get me the money to get to him right away. No, we should not wait. What you need to do is... Listen, what you need to do is meet me at that place I told you about at sunrise. It's usually pretty empty that early in the morning. Fine. Bye.
Kept you.
Wanted to get a donut.
Jesus, Kevin. So what exactly did your friend say you could do for me?
Oh. Nothing.
Why? What about the payoff?
Why would I help you get out of this? You killed my sister!
I told you I didn't do it.
How come every bit of information I received points to you being guilty?
How could you think that?
You owe $20,000 to the guy who runs the crossroads, you junkie fuck. That insurance money sure would be helpful now, wouldn't it?
But I'd never kill Maggie.
All the evidence is there in black and white, Dave. I mean, Christ, the cops even found the knife on you.
What knife?
911. What is your emergency?
Yeah, my brother-in-law went crazy. He attacked me with a knife and I shot him. I need help now!
Hey, hey, gotta stay away. Don't let it slip away. Don't think that they're not waiting. Hey, hey, gotta stay away. As your mind is peeled away. But this just seems to find you anyway.
So that's it, you guys. That was Hidden Intent, our very first feature. You know, obviously a little rough around the edges, but we hope you enjoyed it anyway. Thank you very much for watching this first flashback episode of The Horror Show. There will be more coming in the future, but until then, I've been Cecil Laird.
I'm Producer Dave.
And remember, stay scared of all of your old projects.
Yes.